Hi, welcome to Mendoza's wine country inside out. Today I take you to Bodega Kaikén, where Carolina Macaja, the manager of tourism, is going to show us around. Enjoy the show.
Hi, welcome to Kaikén Winery. We are located in Estalda, in Ojano de Cuyo. We are happy to be able to host visitors in this tasting room where one can taste from our younger, fresher wines to our Reserva, Gran Reserva, or the Icon wines. Kaikén means wild goose. These animals fly from one side to the other of the cordillera of the Los Andes Mountains in the south of Argentina and Chile. So we name ourselves after this bird because the owners of Kaikén Winery are the Montes, the aureliomontes and his colleagues at Vineyards in Chile. So aureliomontes came in 2000 to look for a nice vineyard, nice winery where to invest in Argentina. So he bought this winery and the old vineyards. We're going to visit a very old 85-year-old Cabernet Sauvignon vineyard and more than 100-year-old vineyard of Malbec. These very tiny, hard-working plants that give us the perfect concentration of Malbec and Cabernet Sauvignon for our Icon wines. So he bought this land and the winery, and the first harvest was in 2002. So he was coming all the way from Chile to here, flying back and forth. So he said, okay, I'm like this bird, like the Kaikén, so that's why we chose that name.
Which is, if you look at the production of Kaikén, is the majority of the wine you produce red wine or?
Yes, we are focusing red wines and mostly Malbec and Cabernet Sauvignon. We make also an excellent Ultra Merlot. When we say Ultra, it means a Reserva wine. It has been 1 year aged in oak, another year at least in barrel, and it will age very nicely. And then we also have these two in the younger lines, mm-hmm. and we have different blends. And so it's mostly reds. In white, we make a little bit of Chardonnay in the younger line with Aldo, and a more concentrated Chardonnay in the Ultra line. And then a blend of Sauvignon and Sauvignon Blanc, which I love. I like the idea of using Sauvignon. Sauvignon is a white grape that has been planted in Argentina for a long time that many people don't like. So we are happy to be able to taste a very nice Sauvignon blended with Sauvignon Blanc. And then we bring a Dos Andrés from the north and from Salta, of course. And that's all. So, and then we make a little bit of sparkling. We welcome everybody at the winery. When you visit us, we will be welcome with a little bit of sparkling. Mm-hmm. But it's not our métier. We are bigger in bread.
Good. Thank you very much, Carolina, for the introduction, for the presentation. And now I think I'm going to be shown the vineyards.
Yes.
Outside. Thank you very much.
Welcome.
The winery that aureliomontes bought in 2000 was constructed by the Italian family Calise as early as 1920. Before you get to the vineyard, you pass the gorgeous outdoor restaurant of Kaikén with the terrific backdrop of the Andes on one side and a nice view of the winery on the other side. The biodynamic aspect of the winery shows even in the restaurant where some feathered friends might visit you while you're having your lunch. You see me with a decent haircut about a year ago celebrating my wife's and my wedding anniversary. So on the way to the vineyard, what you see here is something which is truly terrific. You see the most commonly used training and irrigation systems in Argentina in a very confined space, like Cabernet Sauvignon, a vineyard that was planted as early as 1943, the Malbec vineyard even older, planted in 1910. And you see the furrow irrigation here, and the youngest of the vineyards at the winery was planted in 2011, and that's a Chardonnay. You see the drip irrigation, you see the nets that are used against the frequent hailstorms that rage through Mendoza. Then we went back and inside the winery, where yet another very unique feature of Kaikén was waiting for me.
Now,
After seeing the vineyard, I came downstairs to the cellars with Sol, one of the guides here, and I'm going to shut up for a second because I would like you to hear what's in the background.
Okay, so I'm listening to Gregorian chants. The music provides a vibration which helps the wine and tune process.
So that's the vibrations of the chants have a positive influence on the wine?
Yes.
Okay. Well, I buy that because I saw a documentary about the effect of classical music on water molecules. But Sol, what do you think? What do you think would happen if I changed the tape and instead of Gregorian chants put some AC/DC?
Well, after such blasphemous question, I either expected Sol to answer with a knuckle sandwich, hard as a rock, or the spookily illuminated logo of Kaikén to haunt me in my dreams. So I better look for angelic help, which luckily I found closer than I expected.
What you see when you enter the cellars here at Kaikén is a sculpture of an angel. So could you explain what's the story about the angel and Kaikén?
Yes, the angel, what you are seeing here, was a present given to the owner, and he decided to place it here to protect his business. Yes. The angel is present in all the label of Kaikén wines and aureliomontes wine. It's a symbol.
So after visiting the vineyard and the winery, and so we understand the way we elaborate our wines. So we have our young line of wines, the estate, and then we have the terroir series, and ultra madre, and our icon wines. So we're going to taste a little bit of each, which I think is excellent because it's short, it's not too long, and then we can understand a little bit the different styles.
If you had to choose a first name for each of these wines, which would you pick?
A first name, like a regular first name.
What would the first name of the Malbec rosé be?
The first name for me would be Sunny.
Sunny.
It's sunny, like the sunny day.
Okay.
Because this for me reminds me of a sunny summer day.
Right.
So for me it would be Sunny.
What about the Chardonnay?
The Chardonnay will be Celebration.
Celebration.
Yes, because this Chardonnay, it has a lot of character.
Right.
So for me it's like a person that is always celebrating and inviting people, so for me it's Celebration.
Right, what about the
Ultra Madre will be, in Spanish, Típico. Uh-huh. Will be Típico. For me this is the best expression out of all the different Malbecs we make, this Ultra Madre is el Típico.
Uh-huh.
It's what represents this area.
Okay, so we have Sunny, Celebration.
Celebration.
Typical. And what about the next one?
And the Cabernet Franc is Obertura. Obertura, well, is the name, but for me, it's Obertura, you know, it's the first part of a concert.
Right.
So it's like, it's when you start to feel the ambience of the concert. So Obertura, in this case, it represents something like, you know, to showcase the first, well, it's not the first, but it's one of our icons. So out of the Yucco Valley, it was one of the first, and so I think Obertura fits perfectly with this.
Okay, thank you very much for your personal choice of the names and for the visit. And I wish you the best for the rest of the season.
Okay, great.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. I hope to see you again.
Your wine experience at Bodega Kaikén starts before you even reach the winery, with a beautiful 30-minute drive from downtown Mendoza to the winery, along vineyards and with the Andes rising up like a mighty wall. If you're lucky, you get the typical Mendoza weather, which is blue skies, no rain, maybe a couple of clouds. And once you're at the winery, one of the most striking features is the really beautiful outdoor restaurant it has, with the tables set in a very picturesque way amidst the vineyards. So a great combination would be just to have lunch there first and then have a visit, or have the visit first and enjoy your dinner there. So it's really nice. And The winery itself, the cellars, I just love them, the Gregorian chants and the angel. It's really, really unique. And what I also like is that in the Kaikén Ultra Chardonnay, you find one of the best bargains you can get regarding Argentine whites. So really worth it. Very, very nice white from a country that is famous for its red wines. I hope you enjoyed the show today, and see you around.